In last lecture, we have completed the information about menstrual cycle, which is operated in the female body. So here, the all details about male reproductive system and female reproductive system we have completed. Now, in today's lecture, we are going to start a new point that is called as a gametogenesis. How the gametes are formed in human males and human females? That formation of gametes in the sex organs, that process is called as a gametogenesis, that is mean by production of gametes. So here it is the process of formation of gametes in sexually reproducing organisms. In sexually reproducing organisms, the gametes are formed in sex organs by the process that is called as a meiosis. So here, as we know, the sexually reproducing organisms are showing two types of cells in their body. First, somatic cell, and second, germ cell, or it is also called as a reproductive cell. The general body characteristics are formed or developed due to the somatic cells, and the reproductive organs are showing presence of sex cells, or it is also called as a germ cells, which are specially meant for gamete formation. So here the animals show two types of cells, somatic cells and sperm germ cells, or it is also called as the germinal cells, or reproductive cells, or sex cells. Somatic cells are for the formation of organs of the body by mitosis, and the germ cells are forming here gametes by the meiosis. So, as we know, you have learned that is cell division chapter in 11th science. In that, two types of cell division are you have studied, mitosis and meiosis. In mitosis, the one parent cell is divided into two parent cell. Genetic constitution is the same. While in meiosis you have studied parent cell, there is forming four daughter cells and chromosome number is reduced to half. Means diploid cell is producing haploid cells, and here the gametes are haploid, and due to this gametes are haploid, the cell division which is taking place in those cells, that is meiosis. So here, first of all, we have to see the process that is called as a spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis means production of the male gametes. As you know, the male sex organ is the testes, and testes is consisting of seminiferous tubules, and the seminiferous tubules are lined by the germinal epithelial cells, and that germinal epithelial cell undergoes meiosis, and they are forming the haploid cells, which are called as the male gametes or sperms. So here definition is given, the process of formation of male gametes, that is sperms or spermatozoa, from the germinal cells of the testes is called as the spermatogenesis. So here, by the process of meiosis, the germinal cells are producing sperms or spermatozoa, those are called as the male gametes, which are produced in the testes. At the onset of puberty in males, means the males are showing development of secondary sexual characteristics as well as there is formation of sperms during the puberty age. So here what happens, on the onset of puberty, the hypothalamus of those males are starts producing the hormone which is called as a gonadotropin releasing hormone, GnRH. जेव्हा मुलं वयात येतात त्यावेळेला त्या मुलांच्या शरीरामध्ये काय केलं जातं, त्यांच्या हायपोथॅलेमसकडून गोनॅडोट्रॉपिन रिलीजिंग हार्मोन सिक्रेट केला जातो, अँड दॅट गोनॅडोट्रॉपिन रिलीजिंग हार्मोन स्टिम्युलेट्स द पिट्युटरी ग्लँड फॉर द सिक्रेशन ऑफ फॉलिकल स्टिम्युलेटिंग हार्मोन विच इंड्यूसेस स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस. मीन्स दॅट गोनॅडोट्रॉपिन रिलीजिंग हार्मोन स्टिम्युलेट्स द अँटीरियर पिट्युटरी ग्लँड ऑफ द मेल अँड इट स्टार्ट्स प्रोड्युसिंग गोनॅडोट्रॉपिक हार्मोन दॅट इज कॉल्ड एज अ FSH, दॅट इज फॉलिकल स्टिम्युलेटिंग हार्मोन. And that follicle stimulating hormone is responsible for the sperm production or the process of sperm production, that is called as the spermatogenesis. So here what happens, each seminiferous tubule is lined by a single layer of germinal epithelial cells which are called as a germinal epithelium, and that those germinal epithelials are showing different stages of spermatogenesis. So here the cells of germinal epithelium undergo spermatogenesis to produce sperm, and there are three phases which are observed during the spermatogenesis. These are the three phases. First is the multiplication phase, second is the growth phase, and third is the maturation phase. Means in seminiferous tubules, here the germinal epithelial cells are undergone these three phases to form the mature sperms or well developed, well functional sperms. First is the multiplication phase, second is the growth phase, and third is the maturation phase. So we have to study first here multiplication phase. What happens in this phase? Here the diagrammatic representation we can see the first phase. This is called as a multiplication phase, where the germinal epithelial cells which are lining the seminiferous tubules are called as the primordial cells. So here, due to mitotic division, the primordial cells are producing number of spermatogonia in this multiplication phase, and this is mitosis multiplication phase. This is first phase, where each primordial cell is divided by mitotic division, and they are forming number of cells which are called as the spermatogonia. The diploid number as it is because this division is mitotic division. Then after formation of spermatogonia, second phase here is the growth phase. What happens during growth phase? The spermatogonium accumulates food and they grow in size. Only there is growth, there is no any type of division, and that well grown spermatogonium at this phase, it is called as a primary spermatocyte, which is also diploid. And then these primary spermatocytes are undergone maturation phase, that is third phase. Here we can see third phase, maturation phase. So this primary spermatocyte undergoes meiosis first division. After meiosis first, there is formation of two cells which are called as secondary spermatocytes, and these are haploid. So here, from diploid spermatocytes, from a single primary diploid spermatocyte, there is formation of two haploid secondary spermatocytes, and then these secondary spermatocytes are again undergo meiotic second division, and there is formation of four haploid spermatids. So here, from first to last stage, we have seen from a single spermatogonium, primary spermatocyte is formed. From a primary spermatocyte, secondary spermatocytes are formed, and from these secondary spermatocytes, spermatids are formed. But these spermatids are not mature. When they are forming, or they are showing formation of head and tail region, then these spermatids are called as a spermatozoa. Here we can see these are only rounded structures. But when they form head-like structure and tail-like structure, these are called as a mature sperms or called as a spermatozoa. And here, formation of mature sperms or spermatozoa from spermatid, this process is called as a spermiogenesis. This process is called as a spermiogenesis, that is from spermatid, formation of spermatozoa by showing head formation and tail formation. This transformation of spermatid into spermatozoa, it is called as a spermiogenesis. And in this way, by going through these three phases, the sperms are produced. So here, first is the multiplication phase, where mitosis is taking place, and due to mitosis, primordial cells are forming number of cells which are called as a spermatogonia, which are diploid in nature. Then the growth of spermatogonium takes place, and after growth, that spermatogonium is called as a primary spermatocyte, which is also diploid. And then in third phase, that is maturation phase, these primary spermatocytes undergo meiosis first division, and they are forming secondary spermatocytes which are haploid, and these secondary spermatocytes are again divided into mitotic division, that is meiotic second division, and they are forming spermatids, and these spermatids are getting converted into spermatozoa by the formation of head and tail region. This transformation is called as a spermiogenesis. So in this way, the spermatogenesis process is completed in the seminiferous tubules of the testes in male body. So here, the first phase is multiplication phase. Primordial germ cells of seminiferous tubules are undergoing repeated mitotic division to produce large number of spermatogonium. Each spermatogonium is diploid with 46 chromosomes. Second phase is growth phase. Here the spermatogonium cell accumulates food and grows in size to form primary spermatocell. So we have to remember that the first stage is the germ cell, which is diploid. Second stage is the spermatogonium, which is also diploid. Third stage is primary spermatocyte, which is also diploid. So these are the three diploid stages of the spermatogenesis. Now the next is the maturation phase. In maturation phase, what happens? The primary spermatocytes undergo first meiotic division or maturation division, and first meiotic division there is formation of two haploid secondary spermatocytes. So fourth stage of development is secondary spermatocytes, which are haploid with 23 chromosomes, and then each secondary spermatocyte again undergo second meiotic division, and there is production of four equal haploid spermatids. So here the two different processes are going to take place after spermatogenesis. Spermiogenesis, here spermatid is a non-motile. There is no formation of tail, and therefore it is non-motile, only rounded structure. But it undergoes changes to become functional motile male gamete, that is called as a spermatozoal. If a single sperm is there, it is called as a spermatozoal. And if many sperms are there, these are called as a spermatozoa. So here that non-motile spermatid becomes motile and functional spermatozoa, and this process or this conversion of spermatid into spermatozoa, it is called as a spermiogenesis. That we have to remember. And then again second process is there, which is called as a spermiation. What happens in spermiation? After spermiogenesis, sperm's head becomes separated from the Sertoli cells, and they are finally released from the seminiferous tubules. They are released from the seminiferous tubules, and they are coming into the rete testis. As we have studied the LS of testis, in that we have studied the seminiferous tubules are coming together and they are forming network. Those are called as the rete testis. So here these sperms are coming out of the seminiferous tubules. Their heads are detached from the Sertoli cells, and this process, that sperms are released from the seminiferous tubules by this process, which is called as a spermiation. So here two different processes are there, spermiogenesis and spermiation. What is mean by spermiogenesis? The formation of non-motile spermatid into functional motile spermatozoa. That process is called as a spermiogenesis. And spermiation means what? The mature functional sperms are getting released from the Sertoli cells. They are detached from the Sertoli cells and they are released from the seminiferous tubule. That process is called as a spermiation. So here again we have to see this simple diagram. Spermatogonium, by division there are number of spermatocytes: primary spermatocytes, meiosis first, secondary spermatocyte, and each secondary spermatocyte produces two secondary spermatids. So from these two spermatids, and these functional spermatozoa or sperms are produced with the help of spermiogenesis. So here one diagrammatic representation or tabular form we have made to understand this process very well. So here the primordial germ cells undergo mitotic division, and there is formation of number of spermatogonia, which are haploid. Then they are growing and they are forming primary spermatocytes, which are again diploid. Then from these primary spermatocytes, first meiotic division is taking place, and after meiosis first, primary spermatocytes are converted into secondary spermatocytes. These secondary spermatocytes, after meiosis second, they are producing spermatids. And these spermatids are undergoing some developmental changes, that is formation of head and formation of tail, and spermatids are getting converted into spermatozoa or sperms, and this process is called as a spermiogenesis. And when these mature spermatozoa or sperms are getting released from the seminiferous tubules, this process is called as a spermiation. So using this flow chart, we have to remember all the events related to the spermatogenesis and number of questions which are going to ask in the NEET exam. From this flow chart, we are getting correct answers related some NEET questions by using this flow chart related to the spermatogenesis. I hope you understand this. So here the questions related to this spermatogenesis process that we have to study here. So first question is, what is the correct sequence of sperm formation? As just we have seen here, the four different sequences are given and we have to find out the correct sequence. So here first is the spermatid, spermatocyte, spermatogonia, spermatozoa. Spermatogonia, spermatocyte, spermatozoa, spermatid. Spermatogonia, spermatozoa, spermatocyte, spermatid. And last year spermatogonia, spermatocyte, spermatid and spermatozoa. So can you guess the answer? So just we have studied first primary germinal cells, then spermatogonia, from spermatogonia primary spermatocyte, from primary spermatocyte secondary spermatocyte. So here both are given in the spermatocyte word, primary and secondary. From secondary spermatocyte there is formation of spermatid, and from spermatid there is formation of spermatozoa. So the last option here is the correct sequence of the formation of the sperm process, spermatogonia, primary and secondary spermatocytes, spermatid and spermatozoa. Okay, now the next question here. At the end of first meiotic division, male germ differentiate into. When first meiotic division is taking place, then what is formed? That is the question. Secondary spermatocyte, primary spermatocyte, spermatogonium and spermatid. After meiosis first division, which stage is formed? As we have seen here, the answer of this question is the at the end of first meiotic division, male germ cell differentiate into. So at the end of first meiotic division, sorry, here answer is the primary spermatocyte. This is the wrong answer, because at the end of first meiotic division, primary spermatocytes are formed. So here this is the wrong answer. Correct answer is the primary spermatocyte. So these are the some questions related to spermatogenesis. Now how many sperms are formed from a secondary spermatocyte? Secondary spermatocyte pasun kiti sperm tayar hoti asa prashna vicharlela ito. Can you guess the answer? Yes, so here 2, because one spermatogonium is responsible for production of one spermatocyte. From one spermatocyte, two secondary spermatocytes are formed, and from one secondary spermatocytes, two sperms are formed. So in total, from single primary spermatocyte, four spermatids are formed, or four sperms are formed, but from single secondary spermatocyte only two sperms are formed. That you have to remember for these NEET questions. So related to this spermatogenesis process, some hormonal changes or some role of hormones that we have to study, which are important for the NEET exam. So here spermatogenesis starts at the age of the puberty. As we know, there is increased secretion of gonadotropin releasing hormone at the puberty age. GnRH level is going to be increased, which is a hypothalamic hormone. That we have to remember, this GnRH is hypothalamic hormone secreted by hypothalamus, and only gonadotropic hormones, these hormones are released by anterior pituitary gland. So here the increased levels of GnRH acts on anterior pituitary and stimulates the secretion of two gonadotropins, that is luteinizing hormone LH and follicle stimulating hormone FSH. Means here the gonadotropin releasing hormone is secreted by hypothalamus, and this GnRH is stimulating the anterior pituitary gland to secrete two gonadotropins LH and FSH. So each and every sentence is important for the NEET exam here. So here LH acts on Leydig cells or the interstitial cells, which are stimulating for the synthesis and secretion of testosterone, that is androgenic hormone here, androgen, and these androgen in turn stimulate the process of spermatogenesis. So LH is very much responsible for the formation of different stages of the spermatogenesis process, and this LH is acting on the cells of Leydig or interstitial cell, and these FSH are acting on the Sertoli cells and stimulate secretion of some factors which help in turn the process of spermiogenesis. When there is formation of spermatid to spermatozoa, there are some requiring factors for the process of spermiogenesis, and these factors are secreted or the stimulating the process by the FSH, that is sperms are formed from the spermatozoa. So here LH and FSH are playing two different roles. LH is responsible for secretion of androgens, and these androgens are stimulating the process of spermatogenesis, and FSH are acting on Sertoli cells and they are stimulating secretion of some factors which help the process of spermiogenesis. So here we have to remember LH is stimulating the spermatogenesis and FSH is stimulating the spermiogenesis. That is the main difference here. LH here spermatogenesis and FSH spermiogenesis. That difference we have to remember for the NEET exam point of view. Now, how the structure of sperm, what is the structure of sperm? How the sperms are formed, that we have studied in this point. Next is the structure of sperm, or it is also called as a spermatozoan. If it is a single sperm, it is called as a spermatozoan. If many, then they are called as a spermatozoa. So sperm, that is seed, and zoon means animal. It is considered as the seed of the animal. Just we have seen the seeds of plants, which are responsible for growth of next generation. So here also the sperm, that is male gamete, which is on fusion with female gamete, they are responsible for growth or for the birth of the next generation. So here that is the meaning. So this is sperm is the microscopic elongated haploid motile male gamete, or it is also called as a paternal gamete. It is microscopic, it is motile, it is functional, and it is haploid, and it is called as a paternal gamete. Its size measuring is a diameter of 0.055 micrometer in length, and it is very important point. So here it remains viable for 72 hours but can fertilize the ovum in first 12 to 14 hours only. When the sperms are getting entered into the female genital tract, they are remain viable or they are remain live in about for 72 hours, but they are functional only for about 12 to 14 hours for the fertilization of the ovum. म्हणजे 72 तास ते जिवंत राहतात, पण पहिल्या 12 ते 14 तासांमध्येच ते काय करू शकतात, ओव्हमला फर्टिलाइज करू शकतात. दॅट इज इम्पॉर्टंट फॉर द नीट एक्झाम, बिकॉज हिअर द क्वेश्चन इज आस्क्ड इन 2012, विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स इज फॉल्स इन रिस्पेक्ट टू व्हायबिलिटी ऑफ द मॅमिलियन स्पर्म. कुठलं स्टेटमेंट चुकीचं आहे व्हायबिलिटी ऑफ स्पर्मच्या रिलेटेड ते ओळखायचं आहे इथं. Sperm is viable only up to 24 hours. Survival of the sperm depends on the pH of medium and is more active in alkaline medium. Viability of sperm is determined by its motility, and sperms must be concentrated in a thick suspension. So here sperm is viable only up to 24 hours mhanlela ahe. Just we have seen sperms remain viable for about 72 hours. So here the incorrect statement is the first option. All remaining three sentences are the correct regarding to the viability of the sperm. So this is the question asked during this. So we have to, next we have to study the structure of sperm. So here the four different parts are seen in the sperm. First is the head, second is the neck, third is the middle piece, and fourth is the tail. So here we can see the diagram. The sperm is very much elongated structure, as we have seen here. The head region, very short, neck is present. The central part is the middle piece, and very elongated tail region that we have to see. So in this head region we have to see the blue colored region that is called as an acrosome, and this is the nucleus, oval shaped nucleus, and in the head region there are two centrioles are present here. What is the proximal centriole? Here you can see proximal centriole, and this is the distal centrioles. The centrioles function, it is required for the division of the cell. So here these centrioles are two, proximal म्हणजे पुढच्या बाजूला असणारा आणि distal म्हणजे मागच्या बाजूला असणारा. सो वरच्या बाजूला आहे तो proximal centriole, खालच्या बाजूला आहे तो distal centriole. This is the male pronucleus, we can call it as, and the head, at the tip of the head the acrosome region is there. So these are the four different parts which are present in head. A very short neck is there, and from neck the elongated portion that is called as the middle piece, and this middle piece is the energy giving region of this spur, because they are showing spirally arranged mitochondria. There are about 12 to 20 mitochondria which are spirally arranged, and these mitochondria are producing energy which is required for the spur, for the motility. So here energy house of the spur is called as the middle piece, or this middle piece is called as a energy generating part of the spur. And here is the tail region. The tail, it is double of the first three parts. You can observe here, this is very much elongated. This is the tail region. हा मोठा piece आहे, त्याला principal piece म्हणलेलं आहे, आणि शेवटचा टोक आहे त्याला end piece म्हणलेलं आहे. So these are the four different parts: head, neck, middle piece and tail. Now we have to study one by one. So here first is the head region. This head is flat and oval region consisting of haploid nucleus and an acrosome. So main two parts are there, nucleus and acrosome. This acrosome is very much essential part, because this acrosome is secreting number of enzymes which are responsible for the fertilization process, because these enzymes are penetrating the ovum during the fertilization. म्हणजे त्या ओव्हमला पेनिट्रेट करण्यासाठी जे एन्झाइम्स लागणार आहेत ते एन्झाइम कोण सिक्रेट करत असतं? हे ॲक्रोसोम सिक्रेट करत असतं. सो हिअर ॲक्रोसोम सिक्रेट्स हायड्रोलायटिक एन्झाइम्स लाईक हायलोयुरिनिडेज, हे एक एन्झाइम आहे त्या ॲक्रोसोममध्ये सिक्रेट केलं जातं. दिस हायलोयुरिनिडेज अँड सम प्रोटिओलायटिक एन्झाइम्स लाईक झोनालायसिन्स अँड कोरोना पेनिट्रेटिंग एन्झाइम्स. And these enzymes which helps in penetration of the egg or ovum during fertilization. So on the egg there are three different layers are present. Out of that, corona radiata is one region, then zona pellucida is another region, and vitelline membrane is the third region. So these different layers we have to study in the next lecture. So here these different layers which are present around the ovum, those layers must be break, and after breaking the spur is getting entered into the ovum and the fertilization process is completed. So here for the breaking of these walls around the ovum, and these walls are made up of different materials, and for that different enzymes, some are hydrolytic enzymes and some are proteolytic enzymes. Means here proteins are broken. Lytic means lysis, lysis means breakdown. So the lytic membrane, protein membrane is lysed by these enzymes, zonalysin and corona penetrating enzyme, and the hydrolytic enzymes, hyalourinidase. So here we have to remember different enzymes which are secreted by these acrosome. So here are three enzymes we are seeing. First is the hyalourinidase, which is hydrolytic enzyme, and two proteolytic enzymes, zonalysin and corona penetrating enzymes. So here these three enzymes are secreted by this acrosome, which helps in penetration of the egg during fertilization. That we have to remember. Now the next point is the neck. Neck, it is very short region having two centrioles as proximal centriole and distal centriole. In the neck region these centrioles are present. What is the role of the centriole? It is responsible for the division. But in this structure what it play a role that we have to see in the fertilization process. So till that you have to only remember that neck region is having two centrioles. Okay. Now the middle piece, which is acting as a powerhouse for the sperm, because it is consisting of 10 to 14 spirally coiled mitochondria, which are also called as a Nebenker. These spirally arranged mitochondria are also called as a Nebenker, and they are around the axile filament. Axile filament means the sperm's proper center-like filament. That's why the axile filament is called. त्याच्या भोवती आपल्याला हे स्पायरली अरेंज झालेली मायटोकॉन्ड्रिया बघायला मिळतात. अँड दीज मायटोकॉन्ड्रिया आर प्रोव्हाइडिंग एनर्जी फॉर द मुवमेंट ऑफ स्पर्म इन टू द फिमेल जेनिटल ट्रॅक. व्हेन सेक्शुअल इंटरकोर्स इज टेकिंग प्लेस, द स्पर्म्स आर इजॅक्युलेटेड इन द फिमेल जेनिटल ट्रॅक अँड द स्पर्म्स हॅव टू स्विम अप टू द ओव्हम ओर ओजार ऑर द एग. जे जिथं ओव्हम किंवा एग आहे तिथंपर्यंत स्पर्मला पोहत पोहत जावं लागतं. अँड फॉर दॅट दे गेट एनर्जी, दे रिक्वायर एनर्जी, अँड दॅट एनर्जी इज प्रोव्हाइडेड विथ द हेल्प ऑफ दिस मायटोकॉन्ड्रिया. सो दिस इज द थर्ड रिजन, मिडल पीस. अँड द फोर्थ पार्ट हियर इज द टेल. द टेल इज लॉन्ग, स्लेंडर अँड टॅपरिंग स्ट्रक्चर ऑन द सायटोप्लाझम. दिस टेल इज टॅपरिंग म्हणजे निमुळत होत झालेलं आहे, अँड व्हेरी लॉन्ग स्ट्रक्चर फॉर्म बाय द सायटोप्लाझम. A fine thread, that is the axial filament, arises from the distal centriole and transfers the middle piece and tail. There is a central axis present in that sperm, which is arising from the distal centriole, and it is passing through the tail region that we have seen in the just diagram. So here the all about structure of the sperm we have completed. Now related to that, there is one question. Middle piece of the mammalian sperm possesses, jo middle piece ahe त्याच्यामध्ये काय काय स्ट्रक्चर असतं. मायटोकॉन्ड्रिया अँड सेंट्रिओल. मायटोकॉन्ड्रिया ओनली, सेंट्रिओल ओनली, न्यूक्लियस अँड मायटोकॉन्ड्रिया. जस्ट वी हॅव सीन द मायटोकॉन्ड्रिया आर प्रेझेंट इन द मिडल पीस. ओनली मायटोकॉन्ड्रिया आर प्रेझेंट इन द मिडल पीस. सो हियर द आन्सर इज द मायटोकॉन्ड्रिया ओनली. नाउ सम पॉइंट्स विच आर given in NCERT related to the sperms that we have to study. So this point is for the NEET exam. Human male ejaculates about 200 to 300 million sperms during a coitus, means a single sexual intercourse or single coitus releases about 200 to 300 million sperms during the ejaculation. And for normal fertility, at least 60% sperms must have normal size and shape. So from that 200 to 300 million sperms, about 60% must have normal shape and size, and at least 40% of them must have vigorous motility. म्हणजे जेवढे 200 ते 300 million sperms आहेत त्यातले 60% हे normal size and shape चे असले पाहिजेत, आणि त्यातले 40% हे vigorous motility दाखवणारे असले पाहिजेत, तरच फर्टिलायझेशनची प्रोसेस इथं कॅरी केली जाऊ शकते. सो हिअर स्पर्म्स फ्रॉम सेमिनिफेरस ट्यूब्युल्स आर ट्रान्सपोर्टेड बाय ॲक्सेसरी डक्स दॅट वी हॅव सीन. फ्रॉम सेमिनिफेरस ट्यूब्युल दे आर ट्रान्सपोर्ट टू रेटे टेस्टीस, फ्रॉम रेटे टेस्टीस टू व्हासा एफरेन्शिया, फ्रॉम व्हासा एफरेन्शिया टू इपिडायडायमिस, फ्रॉम इपिडायडायमिस टू व्हास डिफरन्स, फ्रॉम व्हास डिफरन्स टू इजॅक्युलेटरी डक अँड देन युरिथ्रा अँड देन युरिथ्रल मीटस. सो दीज आर द डिफरंट ॲक्सेसरी डक्स we have to remember. Now the secretion of epididymis, vas deferens, seminal vesicle, prostate are very essential for the maturation and motility of sperm. So these are different secretions from the epididymis, vas deferens, seminal vesicle, prostate gland are very much required for the sperm maturity and sperm motility. And here the seminal plasma along with the sperm sterilize the semen. That we have to remember, the seminal plasma, that is the secretion which is secreted by seminal vesicle, that seminal plasma and sperms are together known as the semen. The functions of male accessory ducts and glands are maintained by the testicular hormone that is called as the androgen, means the androgens which are secreted by interstitial cells of the seminiferous tubule. In between seminiferous tubule, the testicular cells are present, that is group of interstitial cell or cells of Leydig, and those cells are secreting testicular hormone androgen which are responsible for maintaining the functions of male sex accessory ducts and glands means prostate gland, Cowper's gland and seminal vesicle gland and accessory ducts means greater testis, vasa epiphyncia, epididymis, vasa deferentia and ejaculate. So all these functions are maintained with the help of these androgens that we have to remember for the NEET exam point of view. So here in today's lecture we have completed the process of the male gamete formation, that is spermatogenesis, how it is going to take place and what are the different stages of spermatogenesis and different structures related to the mature sperm, head, neck, middle piece and tail. In head, acrosome and nucleus is present. In neck, distal, proximal and distal centrioles are present. In middle piece, mitochondria are present and from cytoplasm, tail is formed. So, in today's lecture, we have completed this spermatogenesis process and structure of sperm. The next lecture, we have to study in the next lecture, that is how the female gamete is formed, that is called as oogenesis, that we have to study in the next lecture. Till then, thank you.